Yes.
Sacrifice. Relax. It's a right of relax. So this is not a trick you're doing. It's not a it's a counting tool. So you used to count the ball softly and then control the ball. So you guide the ball. Don't try to see that. If the ball comes quickly, you're like zone, you're hard. This is a counting tool. It's very powerful, it's very good counting. But it's more for saving the ball, for guiding the ball, for allowing the ball. So you're exchanging machines, you're exchanging the machines, you're exchanging the machines. Wherever it is, you guide. It's a move, you guide, it's a move, you guide. And you put it on, you want to speak to your friend, you want to guide, you guide, you all come back down. Don't speak to me, you guide. It's a rather short.
crease is so middle. I was like, alright, it's either.
Nice, heavy spin.
Hold or it's not hold.
So I'm saying when you have that shot, you don't stay confident that you're confident with that shot.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Things whatever, but the thing is that if you know what you're doing and you do the right thing, you will see the progress that you do. But if you have something that doesn't make sense, it's good because people don't always tell you what you're supposed to be doing. But if you have an idea what you're supposed to be doing, you do it, right? And you calibrate, let yourself accept that this is a part of reading the spin or reading the ball, particularly the ball by place, right? And seeing the ball off, I think I can do a stroke, right? Based upon how my stroke goes, so if I go over the ball, lower arc, close ball. If I go higher up in the ball, higher arc, right? So therefore, if I make a bad contact and the ball goes lower, I can tell that I hit too low in the ball, right? If the ball arc is low but safe on the table, I hit the right point but I went over the ball. If the ball arc is high but on the table, I made good contact but my stroke finished with a high arc. When I should have kept it low, high arc will give you, if you make right contact, high arc will give you safety. It also gives the right person a hitting height, if they are there on time. But the high arc, sometimes you want to come short and you want that safety because knowing your customer. If the customer is standing so far back, like, you know, the higher up is given, like, if you have a defender, for example, defenders, they want to give it back there. If you higher up the ball falls short, you bring them in. Unless they can count it very, very well, they want to chop the ball to them from below the table. Sometimes they pull it from over there, so they pop it up higher, and then you cream that ball. Depends on what your customer is. You know? So for me right now, I don't mind the higher up, I don't break the ball. Wow. Can you get that right? Look at that. My backhand is, I hit the back ball, yeah, it's too rubber. So, push the table, I have a double like two, but I'm still figuring out exactly what the correct contact depth of this is. But it's coming slow, and I get a good idea what I should do. If I react, I'm just going to slow. I can get the great quality backhand, but I even get the back in time.
You don't die.
Just take the ball right into the close.
I try to win points.
Anyway,
ball back as many times as possible.